Hey guys, how are you doing? So I have something quite cool today. I found a way to set up the width for all of your containers on a global level. Let me show you what I mean. With a few lines of CSS, you can change your whole website to a different width if you want to. And this is so much better than without it, because without it, you have to set up the width for every single container manually, and then also go to the different breakpoints and also set up your width over here. So let's say that your client or you wants to have a different width on the website, you have to go into every single container and change the width settings. And you cannot use copy and paste because this container has completely different settings than this container, as you can see. So without global settings, it's a pain in the ass. So I'm really happy that this is now possible on a global level. And the second benefit of using this little code is that you can have more breakpoints than what Elementor provides. Because by default, Elementor only gives us 3 breakpoints, desktop, tablet, and mobile. And yes, I know you can go into manage breakpoints and add a few more breakpoints over here, but still you are limited to these 6 breakpoints. And from what I've been testing, that wasn't enough, because if you, for example, would use percentages for a section like this, then the website will become too wide. So I wanted more breakpoints. And with this method, you can add even more breakpoints if you want to. So let me show you how this works. And I don't know if you remember, but 6 months ago, I discovered that the 1140 grid is actually 1120. This is still true, because if you work in a tool like Figma, you want to start with some kind of width, right? Something that looks realistic, because the last thing that you want is that you design something in a tool like Figma, and then you build it and it looks completely different. So using the 1140 grid, which then becomes 1120, is still a great idea when you're designing in Figma or XD, or even whatever you use. And within Elementor, I did the same, because otherwise on big screens it would become too wide, but that now is solved because you can add multiple breakpoints. So this means that I'm now switching to percentages all the way for desktop, tablet, and mobile. Before this, in my last video, I said for desktop I'm gonna stick to pixels, and then for tablet and mobile I'm gonna go to percentages. But now it's just percentages all the way. You can change them however you want on a global level. Okay, let me show you how this works. So the code that you need to use is on the website, the new website, by the way. Have you seen it? It's really cool. So you need to copy this code. So let's do that. Copy, and then you can paste it in 3 different places. First of all, you can go to the settings icon over here, then to advanced, and then you can paste it over here. I'm not sure if that is the best method because it's on the page level, because we're now in page settings. So what you can also do is you can go to the site settings over here and then go to custom CSS and paste it over here. And the last place where you can add it is in Elementor, and then custom codes, create a new custom code, name it box container, put it in the head, and then paste it over here. And that also works. But there is a little difference. If you paste it in the custom code, then you need to keep the starting style tag and the closing style tag. But if you paste it inside of your site settings, then you should delete that, because this is already a style sheet. That's how it works. So make sure to paste it in here. For this tutorial, I'm not going to paste it in the site settings. You should do that. But I'm going to paste it in the page settings, because then you can see live what's happening, which is nice for if you're testing it, right? But if you're done, put it in the site settings, custom CSS. Okay, so now if you've pasted it over here, you deleted the style tags, you see what's happening here. So it's called cbox, that is the class, but how do you activate it, right? Because right now, for example, this section is based on pixels, so it doesn't do anything, it stays pixels. So what you need to do is you need to go to the advanced tab and then type in over here c-box, and if you type that, then it will use the class. It still doesn't work because over here we have put a value in. So we should delete that, and then it will take on the class that you've created over here. So now it should work.
Oh, by the way, I forgot to say that you need to turn off the standard padding that they add to each container. Otherwise, you can get issues with alignment. So make sure that in your site settings, under the layout tab, the container padding is on 0. By default, there is some padding, and then it's not aligned. So if you put this on 0 or just unlink it and update it, then everything should work fine.
I'm gonna update it. I'm gonna go to the page, and now this one should scale beautifully. There you go. Scales again, scales again, scales again. beautiful. As you can see, all percentages. It's not too wide, even on a full HD screen. And if the screen becomes even bigger than 90:20, then it becomes even smaller. And if you want, you can add more breakpoints in here. So let's say that you think this jump is too big. You just copy this, you paste it, you add, 3,000 pixels over here. It doesn't really matter. And then put this, for example, on 60%, right? So it's a jump from 65, 60, 55. I think this is fine, so I'm gonna leave it like that. So what you can simply do is just copy this C box and then go over here, advanced, and put it in this one as well. Make sure that there's no value over here and put the C box in. Same with your heading. So now we can easily change the width. Right now we are on laptop big because with the panel on the left, you can see that it's 1560 pixels. So that means that we're in this scale because we're above this one and we're not touching that one. So that means that if we change this value now, it will change beautifully. Here you can see a video on how it looks on a MacBook, on a tablet, and on a mobile. But if you don't like the values, you can of course change it here. So let's say that you have a section like this, which is a lot smaller. Well, then you just simply don't put the C box here, and then you can just use the values over here. But these are just a few sections on each website. So if you use a little bit of CSS and you use this feature over here, you can unlock a lot more with it, which is really cool. I've also created classes to set up the padding for each section on a global level, because on each website you maybe have a big padding over here, which is the same over here. You have a smaller padding over here. So why change it on every single page if you can do it on a global level? I got inspired by using Bricks actually, because they have a brilliant class system, which I think Elementor should have as well, so we don't have to mess with code, which we have to do right now. But until Elementor has classes, you can use these values. And of course, feel free to add breakpoints and change the percentages. Normally, I don't do these quick videos, but I'm trying to be less perfectionistic with my channel because I want to upload a little bit more. So I hope that you can also appreciate these kind of short uploads. If you do, let me know. Leave a like and a comment. And also the developers that are watching, if you think I'm doing something wrong here, let me know, right? Because the beautiful thing about the new website is that I can change it. So I will put the link to this page in the description. And if I find something better, then I'm just gonna change this page and you will have the most updated code. So the more global we can do, the more happier I become, and I hope you as well. So thank you, and hopefully I will see you in the next video on Living with Pixels.